Okay, hello and welcome to a brand new quizzing tournament. This, I don't know what we are going to call it. We'll call it Mega Quiz Tournament or Tournament of Champions or Best of the Best or the Tournament of Goats. This is something that we always wanted since we started quizzing with members and the quiz shows. And all of you, basis your comments, have been demanding this for a long time to make a fusion kind of a thing where people who you've loved on Quizzing with the Comedians earlier, people who you've seen on Quizzing with the Members, and people who you've seen in the quiz show have all come together for this beautiful tournament. This has been one of the most exciting tournaments in a long, long time. Like, this is something new that we are trying, and I'm very excited that everybody in the team is very excited. We actually did an informal survey wherever we went for the quiz show. We went to Chennai, Bangalore, of course, Mumbai and Calcutta and Delhi. And we asked them, like, which are the comics that you would want to quiz with if you win here. And on basis that, we did some shortlisting of the comics. So there are 8 comedians who are going to be part of this tournament, who you've all seen earlier in several quizzing tournaments. And then there are going to be 4 people from Quizzing with the Member series and 4 from the quiz show. And yeah, and then 16 and then 8 and 4 and 1 champion. 1 goat will be crowned soon in the next few weeks, every Sunday, as always. We are starting with the first stellar lineup, the first quarterfinal. And the first person I'm calling is a legit goat of quizzing. He's won so many quizzing editions, been in the finals of so many editions, one of the most loved contestants. Give it up for Ashish, Shakya.
Hello.
Jack, welcome back. It's been a while.
It has been a while. It's been quite a while. I've just been watching other people quiz on your streams and the other quizzing live show that you've been doing. So I'm talking to you about it. So it's fun. It's fun.
I was excited. Okay, it has happened so many times in quizzing that I introduced Rohan after Ashish, and I'm doing that again, but this is a different Rohan. The Rohan you guys loved in the quiz shows in Bangalore. He won all the 3 quiz shows of season 1 that we did in Bangalore earlier. Give it up for Rohan Mitra. Rohan.
Hello.
Good to Rohan, no pressure. Some history is attached to your first name and Quizzing with the Comedians.
Just want to ban Rohan from quizzing. Too much, too annoying, too much winning.
Rohan, you've done offline shows with us. So this is the first time you're doing online. Any difference you feel, or you're okay? It's the same. Question and answer.
Question hai, answer karna hai. I've done a bit of online quizzing myself, like etc. So yeah, I'm just excited. I'm like super excited to go.
Let's do this. And on that note, our star from Quizzing with Members, he won one of the earliest episodes, maybe the first episode. And he's, all of you have loved him in Quizzing with the Members. Give it up for Sanveer.
Hello. Hi, everyone. Sanveer. Really excited about this format.
Yes. Excited to host you. One of the 3 contestants from Bangalore. In this, 75% of the panel is from Bangalore. Rohan, Sanveer, and the last contestant, you've all loved him in quizzing in so many editions. He was the finalist in some of them, semi-finalist consistently. One of the most loved contestants. Give it up for Vishal, Dayama.
Never a winner.
Maybe it's a start, Vishal, this edition.
Tumne baakiyon ka introduction de diya pehle.
Okay, Vishal, excited?
Yeah, as excited as I can be.
Vishal mustered up all his facial energy.
Vishal ka already sara energy khatam ho agle ek ghante ke liye. But yeah, let's do this. Ashish, Rohan, Sanveer, Vishal, you've all done quizzing. You all know how this works. This is a mega quizzing tournament. I'm calling it season 1 because why not? Every year we can do this because we'll do a lot of quiz shows. We'll do a lot of quizzing with members. And of course, 8 people will find every time. This is the first quarterfinal. 16 questions. You all know 10, 11, 12. You know? Let's start. Okay. First question to Ashish. Ashish, this is actually the first issue of New Yorker that came earlier this year. It's the January 2024 issue. In the first issue of the New Yorker for 2024, the cover that you can see on the screen, the cover features an illustration by Bianca Bagnarelli capturing the tumultuous emotions inherent in professional life. Bagnarelli articulates a conflicted sentiment, initially feeling productive during these moments when the world seems to pause, only to later realize she's sacrificing the joy of the festivities, as you can see in the picture as well. The bittersweet realization alludes to a concept familiar to anyone navigating the intersection of work and time. The pressure associated with specific time constraints and the inevitable trade-offs involved. What term, so I'm looking at a term as an answer, encapsulates the essence of these challenges that often evoke mixed emotions? Okay.
Okay. Sounds very spiritual. You're going to have to give me a second.
Yes, yes, please, please.
This is Narayan Murthy syndrome.
wo ladki na economy fly karke gayi hai, theek hai? Please, that's a respect. Is this like a new term? No. Like
no,
this
no.
An old, this is a existing term.
None of those new...
Like they coined a new thing.
No,
yeah,
no.
Okay, not this that. Is a standard term. I mean, only one is coming to mind. Is it FOMO?
Not FOMO, going to Rohan.
Ennui.
No, going to Sanveer.
Is it YOLO? You only live once.
Not YOLO, going to Vishal.
Pass.
Okay, cool. Okay, we'll take another round, starting with Ashish. Essentially, don't overthink. Okay, it's a very general term. Okay, don't think like we tend to, when it comes to quizzes, we try to think of very specific term, but this is a very, very generic term, okay, which is an integral part of any professional life, okay. Now, the big clue in the question is navigating the intersection of work and time, the pressure associated with specific time constraints, okay. So, think of the word you will use for specific time constraints when it comes to your professional life, and that is the title of this cover by Bianca Banarelli.
Wow.
Specific time constraints.
So that word only is the answer.
Yeah, that word is the answer.
Shit. Pass back.
Is it deadline?
It is deadline, yes. First points of the tournament on board. This photo, this cover, it's called deadline. Okay, it's deadline, the beautiful intersection of work and time. And yeah. It is deadline. Mm. Ashish is on board. And now I come to Rohan. Rohan
deadline ko tum kitna jante hai? Kitni sari ko humne well left kiya, well left. Well left.
Well left. Well left. Okay, Rohan, you're direct. This is a tweet by Ian Nepomianachi. Just identify the blanked out quote. And that quote is from a novella from 1945. Now let's look at the tweet. Dear FIDE, as in FIDE, chess. And organizers of the championship, as known, then the quote, is it fair to provide Magnus Carlsen a personal lounge where he can rest and prepare to the game using a laptop while nobody else has such an opportunity? So he used a very famous literary quote in this tweet, which fits, okay, which is from a novella from the 40s. What quote do you think he would have used to complain for this situation against Magnus Carlsen?
The length of the blanks correspond to the...
Yeah.
Not sure about the year, but I'm thinking all men are born equal, some are more equal than others.
Yeah, I'll ask you to improve just a little bit because the quote from the novella is little... You've got the DNA, you've got the sense. I would love to give you full points. But I'm just trying to be little anal.
I said, okay, I'm just like thinking out loud. I said, all men are born equal. Some are more equal. All men are equal. Some men are more equal than others.
I think you should give it to it. I remember. If it's the book that you, I'm thinking of.
Yeah.
I'm sure if it's that book, then.
Robert,
then
if you think of the book.
Animals are born equal.
Yes. It is. All animals are born equal, but some animals are more equal than all animals are equal, but some animals are more equal than others, which is the quote, which is of course from Animal Farm, George Orwell. And now this fits. Dear FIDE chess and organizer of the championship. And no,
ye kabhi Bollywood shoot pe aayega mar jayega. Shahrukh ko bada kyun mil raha hai? Wo smoke kyun?
All animals are more equal. Okay, beautiful. Rohan gets
10 animal ke shoot pe aayega.
Okay, Rohan gets a 10 and I come to Sanveer for the next direct. Sanveer, what connects these five films? Okay, the swan, the rat catcher, poison, the wonderful story of Henry Sugar, and Fantastic Mr. Fox. Just connect these films.
I haven't seen any of them, to be honest. Is it that they're fictional, but they're based on real people?
No, I'll go to Vishal.
Are these movies about same person?
No, going to Ashish.
This is not an exclusive list, right? Exhaustive list, right?
Not really exhaustive, but almost exhaustive. I mean, there might be something else, but it's not one of those questions where we hidden the popular ones. And
My guess is then probably wrong. Okay, hang on. I don't know. I was thinking. Okay, are these all based on Roald Dahl stories?
Okay. I'll ask you to improve, Ashish. So to speak, I would say you've gotten the one half of the answer. Okay, so one more half is missing from your answer. And you are right.
Roald Dahl stories are based on.
Yeah, they're all Roald Dahl. But something else. If you add one more thing, your answer will be complete.
Roald Dahl stories published after his death?
No, I'll get back to you. Ashish, going to Rohan.
I was also thinking only about the Roald Dahl part. And I've only seen this one, the Henry Sugar one. It came on Netflix right now.
Yeah, it's on Netflix.
And I don't know, is it like they're doing some like multiple Roald Dahl books together as part of the Netflix thing? So are these all part of like being adapted, like short movies and like as short movies into Netflix and specials?
Yeah, I mean, these are all Roald Dahl things. These are all adapted into films. They've all come on Netflix, like you said. But I'm looking at something more, like one half, like I said, one half of the answer is missing.
No, I don't think I can improve right.
Cool. Okay. So we'll again start with Sanveer. So now we know, and Ashish will get part points for that. These are all Roald Dahl stories or books or whatever. But they are all adapted by the same director. Okay. So there is one name which is missing in your answer.
Okay? Oh, no.
These are all Roald Dahl adaptation by Dash. So wow, we'll take
was,
one round.
That was dumb just, of me. Yeah.
With just that one answer. Yeah, you guys reached Netflix and Shorts. And four of these came together. Okay. Whenever Sanveer is ready.
I'll take a guess. It's not Tim Burton, is it?
Not Tim Burton. Going to Vishal.
Ashish knows it, no?
I have two options.
Pass.
Okay, passing to Ashish.
Is it Wes Anderson?
It is Wes Anderson, and now the answer is complete. These are Roald Dahl's works adapted by Wes Anderson. And like Rohan and Ashish said earlier, they all came on Netflix recently, Ratcatcher, Poison. The shorts came recently. They were short films. And you can see the images. Benedict Cumberbatch, Ben Kingsley, Dev Patel. Okay.
Patel.
So this was Sanveer's direct. So when it reached Ashish, it was 12. So 6 for Roald Dahl for the first round. And then it became... Okay. So 10 to Ashish, given the progressive point system and how much he got in each half. Which means the next direct will be to Rohan. Rohan, talk about a certain person. In the realm of social media, a familiar face has made a triumphant return, causing waves of excitement among fans who thought the content creator had vanished from the scene forever. Known for deadpan comedic style and astute commentary on race and pop culture, this individual mysteriously disappeared from the digital landscape in December 2018, leaving followers in suspense. After years of silence, the individual has re-emerged to the delight of a global fan base. This personality, let's call him X, who was among the trailblazers for increased South Asian representation, has now partnered with Crave and Pierre 21 Films for an 8-part series titled Late Bloomer. Okay, just tell me the person we are talking about, the person who has made a comeback with this series, Late Bloomer. And bunch of it in terms of timeline and style and fan base, etc.
It's like some superwoman, like an Indian, if that's the person I'm thinking. Indian origin, super girl, superwoman.
Okay, no, passing to Sanveer.
Is it Aquafina or Aquafina?
Not Aquafina, going to Vishal.
Oh God, now I'm confused. Is the person was popular for social media because of social, or was he popular before social media also?
No, no, popular because of internet. Internet star.
Is it Just Rain?
It is Just Rain. Yes.
Shut the hell your mouth, Vishal. Itna time.
Rohan was right in the sense, like Indian origin, Canada,
and I used to star, in, like,
yeah. He was almost in the right city also, like Brampton, yeah. Brampton, like you were there.
Yeah, you were right.
It's the other person from that.
Udhar se, from Rohan's thing, I got. Just
Rain. And Ashish, of course, was part of AIB and Just Rain.
So just like sitting here going, cricket, come on, guys.
How to cricket basics and training.
How to cricket.
Okay. Of course, how to cricket. This is Just Rain.
Number one sport in all learned India.
12 points there to Vishal. And Vishal is also on board now. And yeah, this is Just Rain. Just Rain making a comeback with, has made, came out in 2023. Coming back to Ashish now. Ashish, this is your direct. This condition bears a name derived from the Ga language of coastal Ghana, which translates to the sickness the baby gets when the new baby comes, or the disease of the deposed child. It manifests in children aged about 5 years old, typically after weaning from breast milk and transitioning to a diet rich in carbohydrates like maize, cassava, or rice. The pioneering work of Jamaican pediatrician Cicely Williams in 1935 shed light on this affliction, where she became the first to distinguish it from other dietary deficiencies and propose a link to a deficiency in protein. This condition is marked by edema, an enlarged liver with fatty infiltration, and is believed to result from sufficient calorie intake coupled with insufficient protein consumption. What nutritional ailment is this?
See, in Bandra babies, it happens if you give them gluten. All the ayans and tians have this at age 3. But for other kids, the poor kids, I don't know, man. I think.
So this is like the name of a disease, right?
Yeah.
I only know one disease from this, which I remember from school, which is kwashiorkor.
That's all you needed.
Ashish. Shut up, really?
While reviewing this PPT earlier, this is all I said. I said this is the only disease we knew from school. Exam mein.
Kwashiorkor or marasmus, those diseases.
Kwashiorkor and marasmus. That are the
two diseases. No, I thought it'd have like a cool name because the translation is all like, so I was like, one of those similar rivalry type things.
Yes. Okay. 10 points there to Ashish. It's kwashiorkor from CBSE textbooks.
CBSE 10th standard.
Yes, kwashiorkor. Which means now I come to Rohan. Rohan, during the second Australia-Pakistan test at the MCG, the afternoon session on day 3 encountered an unexpected delay of 6 minutes. This peculiar interruption was caused by none other than third umpire Richard Illingworth, who found himself in an unusual predicament. As the players prepared to resume play after the lunch break, umpires Joel Wilson and Michael Gow were puzzled by Illingworth's absence from his viewing box. This incident prompted Australian opener David Warner to burst into laughter when the true reason for the delay was revealed. What bizarre yet commonplace circumstance befell Illingworth causing this unexpected delay in the game in the Australia-Pakistan Test series?
Yeah. He was watching old Just Rain videos. It happens to all of us. Wine, they got the wine.
These questions never come to me.
Did he have
to They should not come to me. So, mere ko to IDH nahi.
Did he have to go to the bathroom?
No. Going to Sanveer.
Oh, it's not bathroom. Or kya ho sakta hai? Did you have to take a nap after lunch?
Not nap after lunch. Vishal, ye question aa sakta hai aapke, aata hai. Okay, Vishal.
He was stuck in the lift.
He was stuck in the lift. Yes. 12 point there to Vishal. He was stuck in the elevator. This is a moment that happened earlier in Australia. He was stuck in elevator. Okay. Great. Vishal gets 12 points there, which means I come back to Ashish. Ashish, one of those fun questions. Last year, a plethora of apps vied for attention by releasing their yearly raps, as we know. One particular entry by Blinkit sought to add a touch of humor to the culinary scene and incorporated a pun. So the answer will be a pun that pays homage to a legendary character from a galaxy far, far away. Just identify the name that they gave to the character shown below. So the visual is shown below. Just tell me what pun they would have used to refer to this character.
Whose is this?
Ashish.
Mine, but... अभी पन
इतना मैं 50 पन तो सोच चुका हूं
हां बट करेक्ट वाला कौन सा है और अच्छा वाला कौन सा है
अच्छा डोंट एक्सपेक्ट अच्छा एट ऑल
देखो मार्केटिंग मार्केटिंग ने डाला है तो आई अज्यूम अच्छा ही होगा लेजेंडरी कैरेक्टर फ्रॉम फार फार अवे ओके इज इट लूक स्काई फ्लावर
नॉट लूक स्काई फ्लावर गोइंग टू रोहन
व्हाट अ टेरिबल पन
लूक स्काई फ्लावर ओके गोइंग टू रोहन
By the way, were you following their tweets on New Year Eve?
ये Blinkit का?
नहीं ये सारे CEO कर रहे थे ना कि क्या
काम इतना
बेकार है?
मैं दारू पी रहा हूँ।
मैं बैठ के मैं Excel बना रहा था किसने अच्छा ट्वीट किया है।
विशाल देख रहा है कहाँ से ब्रांड वर्क आने वाला है?
Whatever is fun, whatever. Sir, no कहाँ है? Yeah, जिन्होंने घटिया बनाया विशाल will be like buddy. इससे अच्छा तो मैं नींद में लिखी
मेरे दिमाग में एक ही चीज है इज इट Obi-Wan गोबी Obi-Wan
I'll give you a chance to improve Sanveer थोड़ा सा एक just take a pause and think there can be a much cleaner better pun you're almost there that's why I'm not passing
Obi-Wan Ken Gobi
just
Gobi-Wan Gobi-Wan Gobi
Okay, I'll give it to you. It's Gobi-Wan Kenobi. Okay, I'll give it to you. Okay, it's Gobi-Wan Kenobi. Okay, this is nice. Gobi, as you saw. And of course,
I didn't even go. Why didn't I go Hindi for that?
Yeah. Of course, upon Obi-Wan Kenobi, it is Gobi-Wan Kenobi. Okay.
Well done.
Okay, so 12 to Sanveer as well. Sanveer is also, everybody is in scoreboard. Right in time. Just one question before the first half ends. This is a question for Vishal now. Vishal, I need an artist and a song in your answer, okay? So, in response to Bob Dylan's Getting Away with Murder style of songwriting, X, a member of a prominent band, so X is a member of a popular band, penned Y, Y is the song, X is the guy, Y is the song, a song characterized by its enigmatic and whimsical lyrics. The inspiration for the song struck Y when he received a letter from a student who revealed that their English teacher had assigned the class to analyze songs by Y's band. Why wrote this song to confuse those who tried to interpret it. The song has eclectic sources such as Lewis Carroll's Through the Looking Glass, Humpty Dumpty, Shakespeare's King Lear, and the rhythmic chanting of Hare Krishna. Tell me the artist and the song.
George Harrison of Beatles.
Okay.
The artist, I think. And... song is Get Away With Me.
No, going to Ashish.
Was the artist not correct?
No. Going to Ashish.
Yeah, Vishal, correct artist deta main fir try kar leta.
Arey yaar, main Hare Krishna main udhar hi chala gaya.
And I know there's a song by like But it can't be. There's a song about Hare Krishna by like these white people. Like there's a band. Like you know what I'm saying?
But I
know the band, but that's like damn obscure. And that doesn't have the other stuff. That just has the chanting. Is it Freddie Mercury and Bohemian Rhapsody.
No, going to Rohan.
Yeah, I'm fairly sure the song is I'm the Walrus by Beatles.
Okay.
Ab woh hi hai ki X mein you need the specific band member. दोनों में से कोई एक होगा मकार्टनी और लेनन में से जॉनन
यस परफेक्ट बट रोहन आई वुड हैव गिवन गिवन टू इवन इफ यू सेड मकार्टनी बिकॉज़ आई एम द वॉलरस वाज द मोर इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट एंड दैट्स व्हाई डिडंट रिएक्ट टू विशाल फॉर जॉर्ज हैरिसन बिकॉज़ इवन इफ विशाल हैड सेड आई एम द वॉलरस एंड जॉर्ज हैरिसन आई माइट हैव आस्क्ड हिम टू गिव अ बेटर गिफ्ट But because Beatles was for, more or less, it was there, right? Hare Krishna, big band, people are analyzing their songs and all that. So Lennon, theek hai. But I'm the Walrus was a big crack and Rohan fantastically done. I'm the Walrus. Yes.
This was reminding of you that, you know, that band called Kula Shaker that did a song called Govind Bolo Hari Gopal Bolo. And there's a bunch of white people singing that.
But I'm the Walrus has some crazy lyrics like I'm the Eggman and blah blah.
I'd read the whole student letter.
Yeah.
Where the lyrics make no sense.
Correct. Okay, fantastic stuff by Rohan. This is a great crack. 12 points there to Rohan. And that brings us to the end of the first half. We'll take a quick look at the scores. Ashish with 5 for deadlines, 10 for Road Dahl, Wes Anderson, Funda, and 10 for Kwashiorkor is on 25 right now. Followed, and then we come to Rohan. Rohan had 10 on All Animals Are Equal, some are more equal than others, and I'm the Walrus and Lennon. So all Rohan's points are because of animals, essentially. Animals and Walrus, 22 points there, right behind Ashish. Sanveer has 12 for Gobi Wan Kenobi, and Vishal has 12 each for Empire Stuck in Elevator, and 12 for Just Rain. Okay, so Vishal on 24. Okay, as expected, crazy quiz. Ashish with 25. Right behind is Vishal with 24. Right behind is Rohan with 22. And just one question behind is Sanveer with 12. Okay, and two of you will qualify for the semis. We'll start the second half now. The order changes now. Order reverses. Reverse in few bounds. Vishal, Sanveer, Rohan, Ashish. So this will be a direct for Vishal. Vishal, Naman Gupta is the creative mind behind Code Effort, a company that specializes in producing toys and pillows made from an unconventional recycled material at its factory in Noida. Naman, residing in a flat with roommates, observed a concerning trend in the rapid accumulation of waste. This realization prompted him to address the environmental impact of a ubiquitous item, widely regarded as the most littered item on the planet. Through innovative thinking, Naman established India's inaugural recycling center dedicated to transforming this specific waste product into a valuable resource. To date, this center has successfully repurposed more than 200 crore units of what common item?
Is it cigarette butts?
It is cigarette butts, cigarette ends. 10 points there to Vishal. He saw his
roommate dekha and
roommate ka sutte ka ho raha tha and yeah these pillows etc are all made from recycled cigarette ends.
Okay, nice.
10 points there to Vishal and I come to Sanveer for the next direct. Sanveer, this your answer will be a novel. Okay, in the world of economics, this beloved novel has served as a timeless reference, weaving its characters through the intricate fabric of economic theory. Its protagonist, after enduring 28 years of solitary existence on an island, becomes an unwitting muse for economists. From the pen of Karl Marx to the lectures of Milton Friedman, this character embarks on an unexpected journey through the annals of economic literature, appearing in Das Kapital, The General Theory, and even finding a place in Google's chief economist, Hal Varian's textbook. A one-person economy akin to a certain marooned individual becomes a didactic benchmark, simplifying the principles of supply and demand. The novel, in its peculiar way, raises questions about the harmony of decision-making in more complex economies and explores the possibility of replicating this equilibrium. Tell me, which novel, cherished by economists, is this? And bunch of clues here and there.
Pretty cool, yeah. I haven't heard of this book, but I want to read it.
Mm-hmm.
I'll just take a guess. Is it Black Swan?
Not Black Swan. If it has to be something that came before the capital. Okay, going to Rohan.
Yeah, 28 years of solitary existence. I'm thinking something like Castaway.
No. Going to Ashish.
Solitary part is throwing me off. I'm just going to say Robinson Crusoe.
Yes, that's it. It is Robinson Crusoe. 12 points there to Ashish. And Castaway, yes, I mean, the person does get cast away in the novel, Robinson Crusoe, but he essentially spends 28 years on an island, etc., etc., etc.
I thought he found like a guy on the island and I was confused.
Yeah, because
like Friday was there.
Yeah. And the novel came in 1719 and so early 18th century. So timeline-wise, it has to be before Marx.
Correct.
And,
I think it's called the first novel. I think it was one of the first novels ever.
Yeah. Yes, inspired so many novels and genres, etc. It's Robinson Crusoe. 12 points there to Ashish. And I come to Vishal. Vishal, in the quirky world of indie games, Gabe Cuzzillo, Maxi Boch, and Bennett Foddy introduced their latest creation following the success of their prior hit, Ape Out. This game adopts a literal approach to walking as players guide Nate, a onesie-wearing character, using triggers to lift and plant each foot. Initially feeling the pressure to confront the world, Nate finds himself in a surreal, lonely land. The soundscape, a nascent music concrete, triggers environmental sounds tied to players walking, guiding them to unique discoveries. What playful game concept is encapsulated in the title? So title you have to give me, which embodies Nate's journey through awkwardness, mistakes, and unexpected encounters, inviting players to take small and cautious strides towards their destination. Okay, so have a look at the question again. There are enough hints. And just one thing I want to say to all of you, just like the first question, deadlines, is don't think too technical or some gaming thing or some famous game. The answer can be derived from just what's happening here.
Shit, okay? I'm still bummed out about the first question.
Yeah. And we are looking at a two-word answer. Okay. Just clarifying.
Is it a new game? Indie game ka matlab kya hota hai? Board game hi hai na ye? Ya wo?
Nahin. Online hai.
Oh.
But why? Again, clarifying ki game ke root se better hai ki just kya ho raha hai usse two-word answer aa jana chahiye. But हाँ, board game नहीं, PS5, Xbox वगैरह पे खेल सकते हो online.
Is it a phrase, two word common phrase, or is normal words only?
क्योंकि two नहीं, normal words only. As in एक example दे phrase का, like two word phrase.
मतलब caution ahead.
अच्छा वैसा. Can't say anything abhi to. Matlab, fir aisa lagega tu aisa soch raha tha, main aisa soch raha tha.
Achha. Okay.
Maybe not.
Take caution something.
Not take caution. Going to Sanveer.
Random walk.
Not random walk. Going to Rohan.
And growing up.
Not growing up. Going to Ashish.
Is it try again?
Not try again. Okay, we'll start again with Vishal. But yeah, growing up is a good direction, so to speak, because just think of very basic two-word term. Now I'll give you a hint for that. Taking dash dash, okay, in a sentence, if I say taking dash dash, I'm basically saying you're in the first stage.
Okay.
Of got a long it. Process or a challenging
got
process.
It.
And now when you read, now I'm not giving any extra hint, Rohan, Ashish, but I'm just
underlining. Way. So okay. Stupid. Is it, there's a big...
It's yeah. My turn.
Yes, Vishal.
Baby steps.
Yes. Baby step is the game.
Onesie wearing character.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Cool. So baby steps, Vishal gets 5 points for that, which means the next direct will be to Sanveer. Sanveer in 2003... amidst political tensions, a renaming took place in a North Carolina restaurant, marking the birth of a term that later echoed through congressional cafeterias. Spearheaded by Bob Ney, the then Republican chairman of the Committee on House Administration, the menu item underwent a transformation that reverberated beyond culinary circles. This symbolic act was a response to Daesh's stance against the proposed invasion of Iraq. Despite the heated debate, a Daesh embassy spokeswoman downplayed the issue, emphasizing the importance of broader diplomatic relations over the nomenclature of food items. What are we talking about here?
I think this is that freedom fries, French fries.
Yes, yes. Those were the two terms I was looking for. French fries to freedom fries. Okay. 10 points there to Sanveer. It is the renaming of fries to freedom fries.
America.
Oh, why? Yeah. Okay. The next direct will now come to Rohan. Rohan, in the early 1960s, a revolutionary literary movement unfolded in Kolkata, India, challenging established norms in literature, language, and art. Spearheaded by Shakti Chattopadhyay, Malay Roy Chaudhary, Sameer Roy Chaudhary, and Devi Roy, the movement aimed to disrupt colonial canons, becoming a pioneering voice of post-colonial freedom of expression. At its core, the movement embraced Oswald Spengler's idea of history, asserting that an ailing culture feeds on cultural elements brought from outside. According to these writers, Bengali culture had reached its zenith and was now sustained by alien influences, akin to living on alien food. Notable writers and artists include Utpal Kumar Basu, who joined the avant-garde cultural revolution. This movement is just titled as the Daesh generation. Okay. I'm just looking at the Daesh here. Okay. This whole revolutionary literary movement is known, or these people are known as the Daesh generation. What is the Daesh?
Kiska ye?
Rohan.
And Bengali ho ke ye nahi aa raha, bahut bura lag raha.
Oh shit, you're Bengali.
Yeah.
Are you Bengali from, like, have you lived in Calcutta or Bengal?
Oh, never lived in Calcutta.
Never lived in Calcutta.
You can use that as an excuse.
It's, I don't know if you can tell. Is it an English word or like a Bengali word?
English word. I can tell this. English word. Okay. The Daesh generation.
I'm thinking maybe something along the opposite of alien. I don't know. Native generation.
The native generation? No, going to Ashish.
I have dumb answers in that same space. The astronaut generation?
Not the astronaut generation. Going to Vishal.
I have the super dumb answer then. Is it the burger generation?
The pizza, not the burger generation. Going to Sanveer.
That was in Pakistan. Burger, pizza. Generation.
Pasta.
I'm also thinking of opposites of alien food. The Fuchka generation. I don't know.
Not the Fuchka generation. Wow. Okay. We'll start again with Rohan. So believe it or not, it is a good track to think of opposite of something. But not opposite of alien. Okay. But something else. That's all I can say. The Daesh generation, an English word which is opposite of something which is there in the question. Okay. The Daesh generation. Okay. They are. Is that helpful or should we add more hints?
Is this the opposite of Bengali
opposite? The Odia generation. The Gujarats completely outside.
The Marwadi generation.
Are Rocky running in the key? It's Punjabi. Please. Yeah, that is the opposite.
Somebody have a guess. Otherwise, I'll give more hints.
Yeah, you need. I think you need to give more. Yeah. Opposite to samajh gaya tha mujhe bhi.
Okay. So, okay, one more hint I'll say, and I'll just repeat what I said. I said it's not repeat of alien, not the opposite of alien, but something else. Theek hai? Yahan tak, that's all I can say. That was my first point. Second point is, second hint that I'll add is...
Yes, I got it.
Okay, no passing to Ashish.
The thriving generation.
The thriving generation. No, going to Vishal.
Is it the Coca-Cola generation?
Not the Coca-Cola generation. Going to Sanveer.
Arey, I didn't think it'll reach. The McDonald's generation.
No.
Ek bar hint dena, which you were about to give the second one.
I was about to say that Bengal was notorious for this in the 40s, and in its history also, but because of World War and all, something very eventful happened in Bengal, something negative. So the dash generation, which is not the opposite of alien, but food. So the dash generation.
The hungry generation.
Okay. They are known as the hungry generation and or hungryalists also.
And hungryalists.
Hungry generation. Okay. And yeah. Okay.
Hey, last one, Anirban jaisa nahi dikhta thoda. Anirban meets Kishore Kumar, top right. He's got the hair.
Yes.
ये मनोज वाजपेयी है नीचे जो बैठा हुआ है लेफ्ट में
ओके सो दिस रिमेंस अनआंसर्ड द हंगरी जनरेशन फ्रॉम एक्चुअली मतलब रोहन यू कैन जस्टिफाई बिकॉज़ इट स्टार्टेड इन पटना ऑब्वियसली इट वाज बेस्ड इन कोलकाता एंड ऑल बट टेक्निकली इट स्टार्टेड इन द हाउस ऑफ मले रॉय चौधरी एंड समीर रॉय चौधरी व्हिच वाज इन पटना एंड देन इट स्प्रेड टू कलकत्ता एंड त्रिपुरा एंड अदर बंगाली स्पीकिंग एरियाज
दीज आर बिहार वाले चौधरीज
नहीं नहीं वही है बट वहां रहते थे दीदार वही बंगाल वाले चौधरी बट दे यूज्ड टू लिव इन पटना ओके सो दिस गोज अनआंसर्ड दिस वाज रोहन्स डायरेक्ट सो दिस नेक्स्ट डायरेक्ट विल आल्सो बी टू रोहन रोहन जस्ट टेल मी द ब्लैंक इन दिस कार्टून ओके दिस इज अ कार्टून फ्रॉम ब्रूक बोर्जॉय डैश डिड यू वॉश योर हैंड्स क्वेश्चन मार्क यस दैट इज करेक्ट फास्टेस्ट आंसर ऑफ द एपिसोड सो फार मिडास डिड यू वॉश योर हैंड्स एंड नाउ एवरीथिंग एल्स फिट्स Okay, 10 points there to Rohan. It was Midas. Which means now we come to Ashish. Ashish, hidden within the realm of document customization in LatX, a peculiar package, so a software package, not a physical package, adds a touch of spontaneity.
LatX mein physical package hota hai, bhai. Sorry.
to an otherwise formal environment. Crafted by Hanno Rehn and diligently maintained by Patrick Bidaw, this package fills a void that has lingered for far too long in the LatX world. You can choose from four options, such as a 270-degree circular imprint with two tiny adornments, a 60-degree circular mark, a pair of delicate hues dancing across the page, and a vibrant twin manifestation. What is this unique feature that allows you to effortlessly grace your documents without the need for manual intervention?
I don't even know what this... Will it help to know what the software... Like, it's okay if you don't know what the software is, right?
Yeah, it's or okay to not know anything. It's like, okay to not know anything about the software. All you need to know is documents and what's happening with the document. Without any manual intervention, you can add something to the document.
So, like, just a clarifying question. Unique feature of this software. So, this only this software kind of does this, whatever this feature is.
So, if, okay. So, just to make it easier for all of you, basically, this software does something that happens in real life. Okay. But you can use it using this. You can do something using this software. But what it does is something that does happen in real life.
Okay. Got it.
Is this like a digital signature?
Not a digital signature. Going to Vishal.
Is it auto scroll?
Not auto scroll, going to Sanveer.
Is it like the call outs, like notes or comments?
No. Going to Rohan.
Is it like a watermark?
Okay, we'll start again with Ashish and make it a 5-point question. Okay, so the big hint is what Vishal was focusing on, which is the 270 degree circular imprint, etc., etc., etc. That is the part to focus on. The hint that I'm adding is, okay, imagine the world of physical documents. Forget digital as of now, okay? And think of something unwanted on those documents. It's not something that you want, like you want a watermark, you want a digital signature, you want callouts. There's something unwanted, but it does somehow makes its way into documents. Okay. Now think of what do you think unwanted thing on documents, like a physical document in an office, at your home, like wherever, which this software basically lets you add that to the document to make it more authentic, so to speak. And you have options like 270 degree circular imprint, 60 degree circular mark, etc., etc., etc. Is that okay, Rohan? If you have
Yeah, I think I'll.
It's something that you don't want, but yeah. Okay. So okay. Oh, okay, got it. I think something you don't want, but to make it look more authentic. Is it like coffee mug stains?
Yes, that's all we were looking for. We're looking at coffee stains. Okay, you can add this in your document, coffee stains. And you have options of 270 degree, 60 degree, etc.
Mera 270 degree aisa draw kiya, ye dekh, main Pac-Man ne sab soch raha tha. Ye sector draw kiya maine 60 degrees ka.
270 degree circle stain with two tiny dashes, 60 degree circle stain. You can use this in the documents using this language.
Nice.
Okay. Ashish gets 5 for this. Crazy. As expected of a tournament of this level, we still don't know the two semi-finalists and we have reached the last question of the quiz. This will be a direct to Vishal. Vishal, in the spotlight of a recent recognition by Libero Quotidiano, a far-right daily published in Milan, this Italian has been hailed as the man of the year. The accolade bestowed upon the person reflects their triumph in what the article terms the war of perspectives within Italy. The phrase goes beyond conventional barriers, as they are credited not just with breaking, but completely dissolving barriers. Which Italian are we talking about? Who is this Italian?
Is it like a person from the past? Can you tell?
No, it's man of the year. It's, that's a, not a, past or historical figure. Yes, sir.
Shit, man. I'll take random. Is it Scorsese?
Not Scorsese. Going to Sanveer.
The man of the year and breaking barriers. It sounds like it would be a woman, maybe. Is it the prime minister? I don't remember her name.
Can you improve your answer, Sanveer?
I don't remember her name. Is it Sophia something?
Oh man, kyun karta hai log aise? Bolte hai ki itna point dilna chahiye tha, ye bol diya, ye kar diya.
It's the prime minister.
देखो बर्लुस्कोनी का जितना स्वैग था उसके बाद मेरे को कोई इटालियन प्राइम मिनिस्टर याद नहीं. Such a shadow, giant shadow. Yes.
Yeah. Big shoes to fill.
Okay, Sanveer, I'll have to get back to you. Going to Rohan.
Meloni, Georgia Meloni.
Yes, it is Georgia Meloni. Man, why?
Hashtag ही नहीं याद आ रहा यार. Hashtag ही नहीं याद आ रहा था.
Of course, is the most famous Italian in India also. For
वही लग रहा था कि completely dissolving barriers, man of the year.
Yeah, yeah, that was a big clue. She was awarded man of the year, and this led to a lot of debate there.
पहले I actually thought कि मोदी जी तो नहीं है. Then I read अच्छा नहीं Italian है. Okay, then
Italian.
I think the real winner of the award is all the memes that yeah. have come
yeah,
to this moment.
Melody.
And the AI generated music. Oh yeah. Man, outstanding.
It was yeah. And
तेरे लिए time cut किया है सर की आवाज में इस video बहुत
Yeah, yeah, this is the man of the year, and this led to obviously a lot of debate there because, gender conversation,
and far right,
and far right, of course, they called it man of the year. Baloney. Now comes the tricky part of awarding points. Sanveer, kya yaar, bhai, kyu yaar, especially in a quiz like this, when the scores are 39-22, 32-40, usme tu kya, ya to pass kar yaar, just. या नाम ले लेता है ओह मैन वाह मैन आई जस्ट यू सेड इटालियन प्राइम मिनिस्टर सनवीर व्हिच इज या द राइट आंसर बट वी नीडेड द नेम लाइक ऑफ कोर्स
या दिस तो यार ये इस पे नहीं होना
एंड दिस इज नॉट सम रैंडम प्राइम मिनिस्टर मेलोनी इज इन टू लाइक हैशटैग मेलोडी वाज अ थिंग मैन आई डोंट नो हाउ टू स्प्लिट पॉइंट्स बिकॉज़ दिस स्प्लिट इज वेरी क्रूशियल टू द रिजल्ट Rohan, acha, just for my conscious thing, before Sanveer said, whatever he said, you knew it is Meloni. Like
I was fairly confident because wo hi kafi sare hint the, ki completely dissolved barrier. I mean, far right.
Yeah.
Main sabse pehle, when I read the question, I thought Modi ji. Ki because Meloni ke saath Modi hai, toh it has man of the year. Then later, maybe, Italian.
To make it easier for you, I also knew, I just couldn't know the name. Toh main Italian prime minister nahi bol sakta tha.
Oh man, Ashish, as the neutral figure in this debate, any input how to split points for this?
What was Vishal's answer? Vishal's answer was
I just gave a wrong answer.
Didn't help.
Yeah.
So because Sanvi has definitely helped Rohit, but he's also saying he knew, which is also fair to assume. Even split, though, I don't think hona chahiye, because knowing the name is the clincher.
Yeah, because even earlier, like Harrison, I didn't give any split points, right? I wanted Lennon, for example.
Yeah. So this is why you are the quiz master, and you have to deal with the
comments.
You have to deal with the comments. You have to read in the comments.
Okay, no. It's fair to Rohan because Rohan knew the answer.
Yeah.
And he knew it despite what Sanveer said. And I'm sure he knew. We've quizzed enough together to know. And we needed the name. There's no way to give part points for this to make it clear. So it was 12-point question when it reached Rohan. But some part points to Sanveer should also happen. So should we make it 10-9-3, whatever. If you look at score, Rohan will be happy with anything more than 7 right now, if you're tracking scores. Yes. But yeah.
I'm actually not.
Okay. No problem. Rohan got this one and Vishal also had a shot on this one. So it's not that Vishal didn't get a chance to get a shot at this question. It was Vishal's direct. Vishal actually got the first shot for this question. So keeping all this in mind, I will give 10 to Rohan. Okay. And 2 to Sanveer. Just because that doesn't matter. Sanveer ka point as of now for score. And that will be the end of this crazy quiz as expected. Lots of ifs and buts. In the last question, we didn't know qualifying. And
I still don't know. Huh? Because I've not been keeping track of
scores. Yeah, you will know later. It was crazy. I'll have a look at the score now so all of you will know what we're talking about. Ashish had 25 in the first half. 12 Ashish got for Robinson Crusoe, and 5 he got for Coffee Stains. Which means, and Ashish, after that Coffee Stains actually qualified. So it was a fight for the second spot. So Ashish has qualified for semifinal with 42 points. Okay. I'll tell you what was happening. Before the Coffee Stain question, Ashish was on 37, Vishal on 39, Rohan on 32, and Sanveer on 22. Okay. And then Ashish, after Coffee Stain, Ashish reached 37. And Rohan and Vishal were on 32 and 39. Okay, so and it started with Vishal. So if Vishal got Meloni, there was no doubt. Vishal would have won this quiz, qualified, and Ashish would have qualified with Vishal. But then this whole confusion happened. Now we are coming to Rohan. Rohan at 22 in the first half. In the second half, he got 10 for Midas and 10 for Meloni. Okay, and okay, Rohan is the joint winner now with 42 points. And Rohan also qualifies for the semi-final. Okay. Sanveer had 12. Sanveer had 10 for French fries to freedom fries. And Sanveer had a chance to assist Vishal to his victory. Anybody else apart from Rohan would have answered Meloni. It would have been very easy. Okay. Either Vishal or Sanveer. So two chances happened back to back. But Sanveer ends on 24.
Sorry, Vishal.
Yaar, mujhe hi nahi naam yaad aaya yaar.
And Vishal, of course, was in fact leading till before coffee stain question. Vishal had 24 in the first half. He got 10 for cigarette butts question and 5 for baby steps. So he was on 39 till question 11 and then didn't add anything in the last 5 questions. And after the whole Meloni thing, Vishal ends on 39, just 3 points behind Ashish and Rohan. Worthy of being in this tournament, worthy of even going to the semi-final, you never know. But all 4 of you are worthy. But this was extremely close and we had to, had to be little...
Dude, Rohans are dangerous. Whatever. I told you at the start. Rohans are very dangerous.
Yeah, but that the end. This was a tough quiz. I feel this was a great, but sorry. All 4 of you were fantastic. Shout out to Sanveer first. Sanveer, always a pleasure to see you in quizzing. And mad shout out to Vishal. Vishal, I'm still. I was thinking.
But that Meloni, though, he should have gotten. Uspe kuch dukh nahi hai mujhe. Because Italian Prime Minister, I think everyone knew.
Yeah. Haan, fir theek hai. Okay. Then I'm feeling good. But yeah, Rohan deserved that. And Rohan also got coffee stains, but uspe aaya nahi in the second round. But that is so, that happens with quizzing. But shout out to Vishal. Of course, big round of applause, Vishal. Always a pleasure hosting you. And Ashish and Rohan, well done. We will see you in the semi-final. And thank you everyone for watching. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well done. Good game, guys. GG.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.